Canada's forests.
They cover more than half of our country.
The boreal forest is the world's largest terrestrial ecosystem. It's a big part of our country's identity and its economy.
Today we're going to explore Alberta's vast forests, and we're going to take you along with us. Now we all know that trees are important. We're going to start out by looking at the science behind what makes them important to us and our environment.
Our connection to the forest is as basic as the very air we breathe. During photosynthesis, trees release oxygen into the atmosphere, which is good news for us, of course, because we need oxygen to survive.
Also during photosynthesis, trees absorb carbon dioxide from the air.
Many human activities, such as producing electricity, heating our homes, and powering our vehicles, involves the burning of fuels. This releases carbon dioxide and ultimately contributes to climate change. Climate change is quickly becoming a major threat to the health of our planet.
Scientists sometimes describe a healthy, growing forest as a carbon sink because it absorbs more carbon dioxide than it produces. Carbon sinks help reduce the effects of climate change.
Young, growing trees do this best because they photosynthesize more. They turn tons of carbon dioxide into the oxygen we need.
The carbon from the carbon dioxide becomes stored within the tree and can stay there for decades or even centuries until the wood burns or decomposes.
Understanding how carbon and oxygen cycle in a forest is an important piece of the puzzle when it comes to understanding climate change. Great! Forests help reduce climate change. They also produce oxygen, which I think we can agree is pretty important. But it doesn't stop there.
Forests also help keep our water clean.
When it rains on the forest, or when snow melts, the water slowly filters through the tree roots, the soil, and thousands of wetlands like this one.
By the time the water reaches a river, stream, or lake, most of the silt and other impurities have been removed.
Most of Canada's drinking water comes from surface sources, like lakes and rivers. In Alberta, that water's journey begins in the forests of the Rocky Mountains.
Of course, it still goes through a water treatment plant before it comes out of our taps, but the forest will have already done much of the work for us.
Governments protect the land near rivers, lakes, and streams to make sure that the forest can continue to filter the water. By generating oxygen and filtering water, forests help support all kinds of life, not only people.
In fact, the Government of Canada estimates that Canada's boreal forest is home to over 140,000 different types of living things, not just animals and plants, but mosses, fungi, and microbial organisms in the soil.
Some wildlife species, such as caribou and grizzly bears, need large areas of undisturbed habitat in order to thrive.
To keep the forest healthy, we must carefully monitor and control how we use it.
This includes how we harvest trees and plant new ones, where we build roads, and how we use the land for recreational activities, like ATVing.
After all, the forest ecosystem isn't just about trees and wildlife. People are part of the ecosystem, too.
Taking care of the forest is one of humanity's greatest responsibilities. So, think of the forest the next time you take a nice drink of clear water
or a deep breath of fresh air. Forests are important to the health of our planet, but they also play a huge role in our society and our economy.
Let's look at some of the ways that people use the forest. One obvious way is recreation. People love to spend time in the forest.
When people need a break from their busy lives, the forest offers a perfect place to escape.
You really get the sense of a world that's much, much bigger than you are. And at the same time, you get the sense that you're part of that world.
Alberta has a huge wealth of oil, gas, and oil sands, much of it found in the forest. The forest is also a place rich with resources.
Many ranchers lease forested land and use it to graze their cattle. And, of course, the forest itself is a very valuable resource, one that has to be protected.
Finally, many people make their homes in Alberta's forests, including dozens of First Nations and Métis communities.
Some Aboriginal people make their living directly from the forest through traditional activities like hunting, trapping, and fishing. And like other Albertans, many of them work in the forest. The forest is often called a renewable resource. In other words, new trees can grow to replace the ones we use.
But because we use so many trees, we have to do our part to help the forest regenerate.
In Alberta alone, 75 million coniferous seedlings are planted every year.
This, along with good land management, helps the forest keep growing and also ensures that the resource will be renewed and replaced for future generations.
If we're talking about human values of the forest, we also have to talk about careers. More than 20,000 Albertans work in jobs directly related to the forest.
Many of those people work in the forest products industry, producing lumber, pulp, and paper.
They also produce other things, like oriented strand board, biofuels, and even electricity. Don't worry, we'll talk more about those products in another segment.
Other forest-related careers include tourism, research, public relations, wildlife management, engineering, the trades. The list goes on and on. Whether you want to work indoors or outdoors, work with your hands or operate machines, work for government, industry, or an environmental group, there is a job for you. And working in forestry means you might get to spend time in gorgeous places like this.
Now, we've talked about a bunch of different ways that people connect with the forest. Industry, traditional lifestyles, recreation, and just the simple appreciation of its natural beauty.
Sometimes these different human values come together in the same place. Instead of having recreation over here, tree harvesting over there, an Aboriginal community over here, and a petroleum company over there, you can have a combination of these different uses in the same place.
Because different users of the forests often have different needs or expectations, they need to work together.
And above all, they must work together to make sure that the forest is maintained and protected for the future.
How can people work together to manage a forest? That's the topic of our next segment.
Much of Canada's boreal forest is virtually untouched, but that changes a little bit with every passing year.
Every human activity in the forest affects it in some way. How do we make sure that the forest is still able to thrive?
And when different groups of people want to use the forest in different ways, who decides?
When we talk about planning, the first thing to keep in mind is this: who owns the forest?
You might be surprised by the answer. You own the forest.
I own the forest.
You own the forest. I own the forest. We all own the forest.
Canada is different from most countries because, in Canada, most of the forest is owned by the public and managed by our government.
94% of Canada's forests are controlled by provincial and federal governments.
Our governments control the forests, but that doesn't mean they own the forests. The forests belong to the people of Canada, every single one of us.
We elect our governments to make decisions on our behalf, including decisions on how forests are managed and used.
Those decisions can be pretty complicated. They involve everyone who's using the forest, how they're using it, and what long-term effects they might have on the forest.
Sometimes it gets even more complicated when different groups want to use the same area in different ways. For example, a forestry company might want to harvest trees in an area that is popular with hikers. Or a petroleum company might want to build a road near caribou habitat.
All of those factors go into what is called a detailed forest management plan. In Alberta, before a forestry company is given permission to harvest trees in a certain area, they must create a plan. Then, the government, representing you and me, must approve it.
The company must describe where and how it plans to harvest trees, and which steps they'll take to reforest the area once they're through.
They have to show that the area they use will once again become a healthy growing forest once they leave. This is called sustainability. Decades ago, in the forestry industry, harvesting meant lumberjacks felling trees by hand, with saws, and then hauling them out by horse. Eventually, hand saws and horses were replaced by chainsaws and bulldozers.
Today, forest harvesting is handled by efficient, sophisticated machines. We can harvest trees in many different ways, depending on what we're going to use them for. But basically, here's what happens.
First, a machine called a feller buncher grabs 1 to 5 trees at a time, cuts them, and lays them down.
Next, another machine, called a skidder, grabs the logs with its powerful jaws and drags them out near the road.
If required, a delimmer quickly strips off all the branches, trims the ends, and lays the logs in new piles.
Finally, a picker loads the logs onto the trucks. The trucks haul them to the mill, where they're made into products we use every day.
Because modern forest harvesting is so fast and efficient, it's more important than ever that companies plan properly to help the forest recover afterwards.
When a forest company makes a detailed forest management plan, it must hold meetings with all the users of the forest and the public. After all, we're the ones who ultimately own the forest. Even after the plan has been created, the company must continue to keep everyone informed and address any concerns.
Every plan is based on a whole set of factors. Type and ages of trees the company is harvesting, the roads they need, and the environmental factors like nearby streams and wildlife habitat. No two plans are the same because of all the specific information that goes into them.
The plans must also balance the economic benefits, creating jobs, making profits for the company, with other concerns such as recreation and the environment.
Fortunately, it's not one side against the other. After all, everyone benefits from the long-term health of the forest. By properly managing the forest, a company helps protect the environment while also ensuring the economic resource will still be there in the future.
That means not just a decade or two from now. A forest management plan must look forward a full 200 years, predicting what the area will be like long after we're gone.
These plans aren't just the job of forestry companies and the government, but for all of us as well. We have a shared responsibility to look after the forests, for our own future, and for the health of the planet.
We can play a part in these decisions right now. We can attend public consultation meetings, or one day vote in elections.
And, of course, some of us will even end up working in the forest. In fact, that's what we'll talk about in our fourth and final segment.
Coolest tree.
Seriously, the diversity in a forest is totally incredible.
Boreal forest is big, and it's a big part of Alberta's economy.
In fact, forestry is the third largest industry in Alberta, behind oil and gas and agriculture.
You might be surprised at the number of careers forestry has to offer, and by all the different forestry-related products Alberta produces.
When you think about forest products, you probably think of lumber, pulp, and paper.
And Alberta definitely produces those things in huge quantities, but the forest products industry doesn't stop there.
With advances in technology and a greater environmental awareness, we're now able to do a much better job of making full use of the trees we harvest.
Many buildings now include a product called oriented strand board, or OSB. It's made from thin wood strands from trees like aspen, which are very plentiful in the boreal. OSB was probably used in the roof and walls of your house. Sawdust and other leftover debris can also be converted into biofuels, reducing our demand for oil and gas used in the generation of electricity.
Some sawmills and pulp mills use the waste materials as fuel to help heat the buildings and to run electrical generators to supply power. This is called cogeneration. Leftover electricity can even be sent to Alberta's power grid.
In fact, at this very moment, the electricity from biofuels might be helping to display this video. It's pretty cool.
The forest industry also does its best to find uses for trees that have been killed by disease and insects.
One of the big environmental challenges facing Alberta's forests is the mountain pine beetle. This parasite has already killed thousands of hectares of pine forest in British Columbia and Alberta, and the problem may become much worse in years to come.
Once the trees have been killed, we have only 2 to 3 years to harvest the wood. If we wait too long, the wood will decay, and it will release much of its carbon back into the atmosphere.
Cross-laminated timber is a special building material that can be made from beetle-killed lumber and a small amount of glue. It is so strong that it can be used as a replacement for reinforced concrete.
Also, mountain pine beetles infect trees with a fungus that turns the wood blue. Some people find this stained lumber quite beautiful. They call it denim wood.
Trees are also being used to create plastics, car parts, and clothes. Researchers are doing a lot of work to find innovative ways to use the fiber from trees.
This means new ways to use trees, more products developed from renewable resources, and plenty of job opportunities for us. If you live in Alberta, you might end up with a job in forestry. This could be your office.
More than 20,000 Albertans work in forestry, so there's a chance that someday one of them will be you.
A career in Alberta's forests can mean almost anything from operating heavy equipment to working with wildlife, firefighting, working in government, or doing environmental research. It can mean working in the great outdoors or using the latest computer modeling software to help maintain forest sustainability.
Along with forest products, there are jobs in other industries such as oil and gas or recreation and tourism.
Just about every forest-related job requires specialized training and skills, however. If you hope to work in the forest someday, you need to start with a good education.
So that's about it for this visit to Alberta's forests. I hope we've showed you that it's more than just a bunch of trees.
A forest provides us with oxygen and clean water, and because it's a carbon sink, it helps reduce the effects of climate change.
It's an important part of our environment, our lives, and our economy. It's also an amazing renewable resource, but only if we manage it wisely.
The forest industry is always looking for new ways to help reduce its environmental impact. You can help by doing easy stuff like reusing or recycling.
And don't forget to take care of the forest when you're out there. Keep your campsite clean and stick to the trails, especially if you're on a snowmobile or an ATV. After all, it's our forest and our responsibility.
For more information on the boreal forests or any of Alberta's other natural resources, visit insideeducation.ca. You can even send us your questions.
And for more information on careers in Alberta's forests, talk to your career counselor or visit WorkWild at workwild.ca.